So today, we have the Battle of the Monsters, Godzilla versus Fin Fang Foom. Who wins? Let's find out. So, Foom is a shape-shifting alien being from the world, bear with me, Kakarantera, who set out to conquer other planets. He resembles a somewhat anthropomorphic Chinese dragon. He has vast superhuman strength to unknown limits, but he can lift way over 100 tons. Like, way over. He has superhuman durability due to his scaly body being highly resistant to physical injury. He's withstand anti-tank weaponry, great impact forces, and powerful energy blasts from heroes like Thor and Iron Man. He can fly with his wings under the speed of sound for an extended amount of time. He has shape-shifting abilities as he can turn into a human and add 32 to 255 feet to his height if needed. Without shape-shifting, he stands right over 100 feet tall. He has a great healing factor as he heals nearly instantly from almost every attack, and he can even regrow limbs, but that takes time. He even has some telepathic abilities as he can telepathically talk to others and control the minds of reptilian life. He has this acid mist that he can expel from his mouth, and it has a high corrosive effect, although it resembles fire. It can quickly burn through almost every substance, or he can channel it into a concussive blast. Oddly enough, he's a great fighter as he knows the fighting style of his people, or he's mastered of it. He's shown great agility in combat as well. And in the other corner, we have Godzilla. He's the king of the monsters. He stands 360 feet tall and weighs somewhere between 100 to 200,000 pounds. He's obviously very strong, strong enough to lift other large kaijus and throw them, and he destroys large buildings just by walking past them. His hide is nearly impenetrable and indestructible. No man-made weapon has been able to hurt him except the nuke that was dropped on him, but he quickly healed from it. Speaking of that, he has an amazing healing factor. He has regrown his heart and brain in seconds. This plus his hide grants him amazing durability that's better than most, if not all, other monsters. His signature attack is his atomic fire breath that he expels from his mouth, and it's full of heat and radiation. This attack can destroy cities and kill other large kaijus. His signature attack that he likes to do is expel this attack down their mouth, killing them from the inside out. He lives in the Earth's core, where he constantly feeds on radiation, making him more powerful. He only comes to the surface if another monster shows up, in which he shows them as to why he is the king. So, at the start of this fight, Foom will add 255 feet, which is his max height he can add that he has shown to his height, because he'll see that Godzilla has a massive height and weight advantage. Now, their height and weight are comparable. So, they're both immensely strong, but I'd say Godzilla has the advantage. I'd also say he's more durable, as his hide has proven to be more resilient than Foom's scales. Also, Godzilla has the better healing factor as well. But at the same time, Foom is faster and more agile. Foom is also the much better fighter, as he's a master of the style of his people. Foom also has more versatility, as he has shape-shifting telepathy and his acid mist. But the only thing he has shown that he can do with his shape-shifting is turn into a human and alter his size. And since he's already at his max height, that would be useless. He can control reptilian life with his telepathy, but does Godzilla count as a reptile? I'm going to say no, because although he looks reptilian, he's actually warm-blooded, so that wouldn't work. And the last thing he has is his acid mist, which won't do anything but slightly burn Godzilla's hide. Foom is faster, more agile, and a much better fighter, so he'll land more hits, but blunt hits aren't enough to take Godzilla down. Godzilla also has his atomic fire breath, and yes, Foom is durable enough to take it on the outside and probably fast enough to dodge it as well, But if he does his trump card and expels it in his mouth, killing him from the inside out, that would put Foom down. And I believe that's what would happen after a long destructive fight. Godzilla wins. Like and subscribe, all the great stuff.